Zeb, name changed, was going to bank. He was eager to draw his monthly pension. He hurriedly filled the form and waited for his turn. To pass time, he glanced here and there and saw a woman in her late 70s coming in. A man aged 38 was trying to help her out by bringing the form, filling up on her behalf, and brought a ThinkPad to keep the slip so that the old woman could sign easily. She carefully signed the document and appeared weary. Zeb by this time turned curious and want to know what is going to happen next. The women brought a bundle that may be around 35,000. The man who accompanied the old woman, appearing to be her son, counted the cash, placed cash inside bag, and helped the mother walk down and sent her in an auto. Then the man rides his bike and disappears. Zeb quickly summed up the event: this man is a pension eater. Walking alone down the stairs after taking his pension that comes around 25,000, Zeb began recollecting his own experience. He has wife and a daughter whom he spent 25 lakhs for MBBS abroad. The daughter had in mind earning more than 1 lakh a month once she completed her studies. Since his daughter couldn't make it, she spent years together idle without doing any job. Her false pride didn't allow her to work for 12,000 in the beginning to gain experience and then steadily climb the career ladder. She felt so, since I am MBBS studied abroad I must get 1 lakh minimum salary. Zeb began to count how many years she remained idle. It was almost 6 years till she was forced to serve during COVID times, otherwise she would have wasted her career. Zeb's current issue is with his wife and daughter who form a team and demand the pension amount. After surrendering to wife who is earning 20,000 monthly and daughter earning some amount which she never revealed her father, Zeb acted finally. He became stern and stopped parting pension to his wife. He started living separated in another place. Although he left 2-bedroom house, car, his wife, and daughter still expected entire pension amount from him. One day Zeb confessed to his friend, "My daughter is a pension eater." He was sobbing. "I have a few friends." In that one, Shiva narrated an interesting incident. Shiva knows a person named Dakin who came to Hyderabad during 2004. He was unable to find a job although he studied a diploma course. Finally, he got a job and worked in a company for a couple of years. Then he went back to his native place. Many didn't know what happened to him after. Shiva became curious after 7 years. What happened to Dakin? He called his friend Dinush and asked Dakin's whereabouts. Dinush inquired, found, and gave his number to Shiva. Shiva saved it, saw a small kid beside Dakin in display profile. Intrigued, he called him and asked, "Whose kid is this?" The man proudly answered, "My kid, my kid." Shiva wondered and began to think, how can this man marry, produce child, live without proper income? From the information got from Dinush, Shiva knows Dakin consumes alcohol every day and chew pan. But where is the money from? Finally, Shiva called up Dinush and clarified how Dakin meets his living expenses. Dinush plainly said, "Mummy pension, what else?" With that he leads the family. Yes, pension eaters are many. I know one man who won't work for years together. His father was a pensioner and was sick. He used it as an excuse to avoid working and meet his living expenses by being a dependent. Concerning this, another man, AJ, who never received parents' pension, commented, "Yeah, both parties benefit as the father needs someone to care and son needs support." Very much indeed, I too nodded in agreement. Then I thought about another man named Sunil Kumar. He was working for some years in Dubai and left that job. Due to recession, he lost his job in his hometown, and his mother was feeding him. His wife having dispute on her hubby's employment status, lives separately with her mother. She has a kid. Now the mother and son lives on her mother's pension. Pension eaters are a class who hardly work. Parents send them to study BTech, MBA expecting to get return on investment. Of course, they work for some time, but the work pressure make them call it quits. They are back to become dependents. There are many who marry without any earnings and depend on aged parents. Since their expectations are high with skills mismatch, companies consider them as unemployable. As a result, they spend the rest of their lives as pension eaters. The most atrocious part is some want the pension to be carried forward in their names after the death of their parents. One thing is clear, Pension eaters are sitting on the cusp of a disaster. In a country like India, it is not feasible to continue giving pensions to 58 million people. With denationalization of banks and disinvestment of public sector enterprises, pension may soon become uncertain. Better late than never, pension eaters, shed egos, should find their call and start generating incomes and be self-sufficient. All the best. More such stories are coming. Subscribe to this channel and have a discussion around every topic. Thank you for watching.